In this video, I'm going to show you the best exercise for the tibialis posterior in flat feet. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The tibialis posterior is an essential stabilizer of the foot during standing and walking. The tibialis posterior tendon provides dynamic support along the plantar aspect of the foot and arch, and when the muscle or tendon are deficient, decreases in longitudinal arch height often occur and can lead to flat feet. For this reason, tibialis posterior strengthening is recommended next to foot orthosis in the rehabilitation of painful pes planus to prevent tibialis posterior tendon dysfunction and foot arch collapse. But how can we strengthen this muscle ideally? Kulig et al. Did an MRI study to determine which exercise most selectively and effectively activates the tibialis posterior. They found the greatest isolated activation with the following exercise. Have your patient sit on a bench with his knees about forearm length apart and flex to about 80 degrees. Then the patient is asked to stabilize his leg by placing the contralateral forearm between the knees and reinforcing it with the ipsilateral hand. Then an elastic band is looped around the medial and distal part of the foot that is to be trained and stretched to full tension while maintaining an inclination angle of 45 degrees. While the examiner ensures tension throughout the whole movement, the patient is asked to slide his forefoot into adduction from full abduction, with the foot remaining in contact with the floor. The total range of motion can be marked with a tape to ensure full range of motion with every repetition. In 2005, Kulig et al. Compared the activation of the tibialis posterior in patients with flat feet and found a higher selective activation in those patients when wearing foot orthoses and shoes. As this is the patient group you would want to give this exercise to, wearing insoles and footwear is recommended. Progression can be adjusted based on the tension of the TheraBand by the examiner or by choosing a TheraBand with a higher resistance. Like with any other rehabilitation program, the total volume of the exercise should be slowly increased over time. Kulig et al. Were able to decrease pain and increase function in their third study in 2009 after a 10-week program with 3 sets of 15 repetitions twice per day. Alright, this was our video on the resisted foot adduction exercise to strengthen the tibialis posterior. If you want to learn how to assess for forefoot overpronation, check out our video on the navicular drop test right next to me. At last, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel if you haven't yet, and check us out on Instagram, Facebook, or visit our webpage at physiotutors.com for more content, or get our newly released assessment ebook. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.